Good morning, everyone. I hope you're ready for another full build on the workshop. I am enjoying these warm February days in Wisconsin. You can watch this, and then you can go out and have some fun yourselves. We are going to be taking a look at Revell USA's reissue of the 1957 Chevy Bel Air, the iconic Tri-5 car. This bad boy is in 1/25th scale and will come with 186 parts in the box. We got some sweet box art on the side by Bob. Beautiful yellow, beautiful stock gold with a cream top. I'm really digging that one. So let's start taking a look at all the parts that will be inside that cool box art when you get yours. First up, you will notice these tires are two complete sets of tires for this ride. Now, something you should know, the tires in this model are packed in with the body. So I highly recommend, if you are a person who buys a lot of kits and doesn't build them, that you open up the shell, the bag for the body shell, and you remove these tires. Sometimes, depending on the compounds used, tires can melt through the body, melt through the glass and stuff like that. So just take the body out of the plastic bag, leave the tires in the plastic bag, and you won't have to worry about that if you don't build it for the next 20 years. And you know who we're talking about out there. Some of you are watching this right now that have kits that you bought 20, 30 years ago that you were going to get to and you still haven't built. So look out for those and take care of yourself. We got a nice set of stock wheels. We can see we've got some white wall inserts that will go in there. You got smooth black wall on the other side and a very common bias ply tread, so you get an entire set of those. Because this kit's a two-in-one, we got an awesome set of modern style lower profile tires, nice and fat. They seem to be identical. There are no brand names on those tires, so that will be a nice set to put on there. By the thumbnail, you can decide which way I went with this build. I'm not really sure yet. Transparent parts in the model. We've got vent windows, back glass, windshield and back glass. We've got marker lights for the bumpers and turn signals. So that's what you got there for transparent. We've also got a set of four metal pins. Do not lose those. Those are to hold your wheels on. We've got one chrome tree here. We've got the rear bumper. We got the rear fins with the tail lights. We've got the hood inserts, rear view mirror. We got the Chevy chevrons for the front rear, very thin. We've got our grill. This is a super, super thin parts tree, so be very, very careful with it. You can see the grill there. We can black wash all inside. It is a very fine mesh, very well detailed. We got a second chrome tree, custom valve covers, steering column. That's actually an alternate steering column. That's the alternator. Air cleaner, two parts. So you could actually paint the filament and then stick it on there. And a sweet set of custom five-spoke wheels. And the spokes are molded open. They're not closed. So those will look pretty tight on the car. Finally, third chrome tree. We've got fuel injection parts. We've got stock hubcaps. We've got water pump covers. We've got stock wheels, carburation, everything you could think of on there. So that is a lot of chrome stuff in that kit, three entire trees. We've got this nice decal sheet, numerous license plates, some classic Revell emblems. We've got all of our stock Bel Air color inserts, Chevrolet. We've got gold and silver Chevrolet decals on there. Numerous call-outs. We've got our gauge package and small decals. We've got fuel injection logos like you would have seen on the Corvettes too. And then this really nice striping package. And if you're kind of wondering how that striping package will work, take a look at the side box art. You can see over and under. So you can sort of accentuate that, and you've got the red, black, silver, and blue. So you've got quite a few options on that decal sheet. Moving over to the other side with all the white plastic. The rest of the kit is molded in white styrene. Nice chassis, frame, all that's open. So make sure to paint the bottom of your interior bucket, or you're going to see a big piece of white plastic through the center there. But that looks very nice. Interior is smooth. You can see our engine mounts in there, our suspension arm mounts. Then we're going to go for our hood. The hood is, you can actually cut these out if you desire. Firewall, radiator support, battery, horns, blower motor, all of that. 186 parts in a car model is a good amount of parts. On this tree, we've got stock steel wheels, we've got manifolds, and full exhaust system in one piece, or each side, I should say, is one piece. Like those Steelys, always like those Steelys, and they do have front and rear, which is nice. Pay attention to detail, and that's what they did. On this one, we've got the other exhaust system, suspension arms, leaf springs, got our front suspension, rear differential, insert for our fuel tank and spare tire. On this tree here, we've got the parts to our V8, another radiator mount. Remember, this is a two-in-one, so you're going to have a lot of parts left over. Fan, stock manifolds, drive shaft on this one, shock absorbers and springs, water pump, stock valve covers, stock air cleaner, cylinder heads, stock intake, oil pan. On this one is the suite interior door panels. They are separate, so if you wanted to do a multicolored door panel, it's much easier to work on. Got our white wall inserts, stock steering wheel and steering column. Very, very delicate, so be careful right there. But those door panels are the highlight of that tree. Back here, we've got wheel backs, hood springs, part of the differential gear carrier. We got our distributor with vacuum, belt and pulley, stock generator, starter. We got lots of stuff. Check out these seats. Split bench, rear bench, front seat frame. All on there. We've got parts for our modified suspension. See the risers for the springs? Risers. Suspension arms. So you're going to have stuff for the parts box and everything. Got our dashboard here. Plenty of room for our decals on there. I love that little bump out there. We're going to make this look pretty cool. Here's our optional suspension if it's been modified. With disc brakes are extremely common to add when you resto-mod a car. You can see where our gear carrier will bolt in. This has got the steering molded in. Nice suspension arms, and I love these, that brake work on there. That is really sharp looking. Then we've got our interior pan. Like I said, you're going to be able to see this through the bottom, so make sure to paint this. Pins to locate it in the body. Carpet detail, this will be nice to work on. Just spray it one color and you're all set. And finally, the Bel Air body. Be very careful, these are thin when you grab the body. Inserts for windshield wipers, they're not molded in. Inner fenders, those will be easy enough to paint if you don't leave them. Body color, the molding is strong here, so we can get in and either detail this all by hand or we can paint it, whatever you choose. Nice roof line, got all the trim around the roof. Excellent back detail where our fins will go in. Rear bumper mounting. Front grille and bumper mounts. I love when they have the holes there for our nice little headlight buckets. Oh yeah, we're going to have some fun with this one. So that's all the parts that are in this 57 Bel Air reissue, and the decals and the three chrome trees. I'm going to start gluing mine together, and you can watch me do that next. Let's go over all the stuff that's glued together. And of course, we're going to have a lot of sprues on this one that will be painted because it's designed to be painted, then assembled and stuff like that. And a lot of the stuff I want to do different colors on and different things with my model. So on this tree here, this is a lot of the modified parts for the more modern one. And as you saw the wheels I was gluing together, I made my decision on which one I wanted to build. So we've got our air intake, we got our blower motor here. For under the hood, we got our horns, and we've got our radiator hose, steering, and battery on there. On this tree, we've got random pieces that I'll need, like the drive shaft and the radiator off there. Now, when I start working on other stuff, these parts here, this is the air intake hose for the supercharger. That'll go into the side of the engine. And we have a little chrome piece as well. This little piece you saw me install, that will be going on the side, and I'm going to leave that chrome. I may end up spraying it with a flat coat to dull it down, make it look more like aluminum or brushed metal. I'm not really sure what I feel like doing at the moment. I do know that I want the radiator support and the firewall to be a different color than the hood and the other pieces of the interior. We got our body here, which needed nothing but a wash and degreaser, simple green, dish soap, whatever you prefer is absolutely fine. We got the chassis here. The only real fiddly part of the kit was getting these springs to sit properly as I glued it down. So what I did was, it lines up in the back right there and lines up in the front with that tab. So then I took one of my little mini clamps, and you can snag these at the dollar store, and I just clamped it closed while I glued it together. And then glued the suspension arms and everything so it wouldn't move. This I will hand paint, but I wanted to make sure that it was on there tightly and it was in the correct position. So the stuff on this kit, for some reason, even though it's a more modern kit, doesn't, it lines up like it's a 1960s plastic kit, which I'm not fond of at all. I'd rather have things with positive locators and stuff like that. This one's just kind of like, eh, put it in here, clamp it, you know, and see if it fits right. And you gotta check the angles on everything. So you're gonna have to do that on this kit. It's a skill level 5. They rate skill levels based on part numbers, but this one will take a little bit of custom fitting and fettling to make sure things are lined up properly, because it's not as efficient as a very brand new model kit where they give you big locator marks. For some reason, even though this one's a little more modern than some of the other kits I've worked on, They didn't make it very easy on you. It's like someone that designed it thought, well, it'll be fun if we just kind of make it vague. But anyways, we put our differential on. We can see that this one's going to be lowered a little bit. The car will be lowered a little bit on those blocks. So I wanted to glue all that in there so I could fit the exhaust in. But now we'll have those disc brakes. You can call them Wilwood. Those are extremely common on retro mods. We got the springs together. I can paint that separate and then attach it inside the chassis when we're all done, once I lay this exhaust system in there, we can get that painted separately. I can get the frame rails painted, decorate the chassis and stuff like that, and it'll be all set. We've got the fuel injection manifold right there in chrome. I will likely be flat coating that and black washing it. And then we've got our engine assembled. Basic manifolds on this, which is weird for an engine with fuel injection, but okay. Got our fuel pump, oil filler, distributor, and coil. I glued the fuel injection manifold to the block. I didn't want that chrome. Got our engine mounts here, water pump, oil filter, starter, and that engine is all set to go, and I will hand paint any other details. That's pretty much it. We got the steering column and the rest of the stuff, the door panels, the seats are glued together, or the front seats glued together, because the only metallic work I'm going to have to do is on the sides, and we can do that with a Molotow pen. The rest of the stuff I'll be painting, decorating as I see fit. So what I will do now is take everything over, get it all scrubbed down with some Simple Green, and then let it dry, and then we will start throwing some paint.
Thank you.
Welcome back. We're going to start taking a look at parts before I put the model together and do all the final little trim pieces and decide on what decals, if any, I'm going to be applying to the outside. Now, as far as when I said that about the decals, I know for sure I'm going to be using the Chevy logo and likely the Bel Air logo, since they're in a goldish yellow color anyways. It's going to look good on the car, but for the rest, I'm not really sure if I'm going to be using a lot of them. I like this to be a resto mod, very clean. I'm not going to be using the chevrons on the front or the rear or any of that stuff. I want to kind of leave it real smooth and nice looking. Now, the interior turned out just the way I wanted it. I didn't want to follow the factory color striping that they would have on the interior. I wanted to do my own, so I did the rough textured part of the seat in yellow, did gray primer, which I like the gray because it is somewhat similar to the metallic that I used on the car. Then I did the yellow for the elbow rail around the dashboard and all the way around, and then did yellow at the very bottom of the doors on there. Painted up the dashboard, put the decals in it, black washed it, looks pretty cool. Did the firewall on there, glued in the master cylinder for the brakes, and we're all set. When I did that black interior for the carpet, then I just misted it with some gray primer, and it gave it that flecked carpet look, that nice little light flecks inside a carpet that they'll weave in. We've got our grill here, all black washed, and then did the orange turn signals. And this is where that one decal I know for sure I'm going to use, because it will look very nice there. And otherwise, it's just a glaring opening. We could color it in with something, but I'll use the logo. Got the hood on. Got the headlight buckets in. Those fit beautifully. For the headlight buckets, what I did was I used some Mod Podge from the back. Glued those in. The radiator support is in, but it's just a nice friction fit in this car. So I wanted it to look like an aluminum radiator, a redone radiator for the car. I did the radiator support, the same color as the firewall. So we're all set with that. Got our masking done. Got our striping for the doors done. Glass goes in without issue. And that's all you really have to do with the body. Used a magic marker to do the little markers on the front fenders. And that's it. You saw all the masking was done earlier, so I didn't really have to work on a lot of that stuff. And then the chassis. Looks nice. Got our differential in, got our wheels on, got our exhaust in, transmission, drive shaft. Got those sweet looking wheels with the disc brakes behind them. We got that awesome looking fuel injected small block. I did it in yellow to match the car. I think it looks great. And then we got all of our metal and other components on the engine, the dress-up pieces with the exhaust, and the exhaust lines up perfectly with the bottom of those manifolds. So that is done there. Pretty much on the trees is like our trim, our air cleaner. We've got windshield wipers, mirrors if you choose to use them, chevrons if you choose to use them, taillights, rear bumper, all that cool stuff. We've got our blower motor and our battery, our horns, all that stuff just has to be bolted in place. We got our air intake right there, radiator hose, just very small stuff. So I'm going to get to putting things together. The interior fits inside the body with these nice two large tabs, so you know exactly where it should go. I've already test fit it on the chassis, and it sits the way it should. Underneath there, just rides over the top. It doesn't sit too high or anything. So once I get that together, I'll let you know how everything went. The small chrome pieces fit very well on the hood, as does the trim for that nose piece. And you can see how well the hood fits on the body. So there's not a ton of work, but it's going to take a little bit. We're going to find out how well that body sits over the chassis and gets fit down. And when I'm done with that, we'll have the final. My Restomod creation from Revell USA's 1957 Chevrolet Bel Air kit is done. The kit is in 1/25th scale. It's got 186 parts in the box, and that means you are going to have quite a bit of stuff left over. Full set of wheels and tires, engine parts, intakes. You got multiple carburetors on the parts tree. We've got all kinds of stuff in there for you to save if you have a parts box. The parts that I used here, everything went on nicely. We didn't have any issues with the final fit. The body actually drops onto the chassis very well. The way they attach the front and rear bumpers is exquisite. My recommendation when you do attachment or everything is go ahead, get your headlight buckets in, drop the body on, then you can attach your front bumper. I just used two little drops of super glue in those holes on the front end. Then what I did in the rear was I pressed in the taillights and friction fit them, and then the bumper, because the taillights up top are held in by the friction of the bumper on the back, and then I glued the bumper into its two little holes, applied the shorter version of the trim on the top here. As you see, I didn't paint the trim or anything on the top or on the sides of the fenders, so I used the shorter chrome trim that's in the box in the Restomod parts. Got those sweet wheels and those brakes. Now, I was talking about those being Wilwood brakes. My eyes aren't as good as they should be. When I showed the decal sheet, these little guys right here are all really small Brembo brake decals. So now we know what they wanted those to be. So you got them in black, yellow, and white. So you can paint those, any, you know, those calipers, any color you desire, and slap those on there. I didn't notice that till the very end when I looked at the sheet again. Love that way that chrome yellow just screams with the gunmetal metallic over the top. And then I did sort of a color match on the inside with just a slightly different shades of gray and yellow like you'd see from a fabric instead of a metallic. The engine at the end goes in together well. Then I drop the radiator in, attach the radiator hoses, and we are all set with that. Then I put the blower motor in, the battery, and the air cleaner and intake for the fuel injection, which was a little fiddly to get in there, but eventually I got it on there and glued it up to the side of the throttle body. So I wouldn't say there's any fit issues. I loved how nice the interior fit in, super tight. Having those posts back there definitely let you know where it needs to go. And then you will just need to press up hard. And once you see that firewall snap even with the bottom of the windshield, you'll see that there's no gap in there. Then you know you have it up high enough. If you don't push it up all the way, your front end is going to stand high off the ground. So you can go ahead, build this car one of two ways, or take it your own way. Build whatever you want out of it. You know, we got the box art here. They've got some of the trim going along and stuff like that. And they did it more in a silver with a yellow roof, same as the builds by Bob on the other side. So I went with those wheels and then just did it a little bit different just for me and the way I wanted my model to look. But I did like the inspiration from the box art. It's always fun to see that. They put in a lot of work on that stuff, and then they always go through and get those great decals on there as well. I didn't use any of the decals on the side. I used the Bel Air logos, and I used the Chevy emblem, the colorful emblem on the front, but I didn't put the chevrons on or anything like that. The door handles fit nicely. A drop of thick gel super glue. I just use this inexpensive brand. Putting that on there makes it a lot easier, just a little thin bit. Use that old school Ravel decal on the quarter windows back there, just because I thought it would look cool, and everything turned out well. The windshield wipers went on. They look nice. I had a really nice time with the kit. So I want to thank Ravel USA for sending this over. I don't know if this is going to be available by the time this video comes out, but I'll link in the description as soon as I have a pre-order available. I will put that on there so that you guys can get it on order, or we, if it's already available, you guys can get it picked up. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks to Ravel USA, all of you, for watching, having fun. Enjoy your weekend, and I will see all of you at the next review.